In the last tutorial, we learned how to figure out the URL of the Oracle Enterprise Manager by finding out the hostname and the port number. To find out the port number, we used getHttps port inbuilt function of the Oracle library. That process of finding out the port number using getHttps port function will only work when the port number is already assigned. If no port is set for your database, then that function will return 0 instead of a valid port number. Now the question is, if this is the case, then what should we do? What's up, internet? I am Manish from RebellionRider.com, and today in this video we will learn how to manually configure a HTTPS port for Oracle Enterprise Manager. But first, I just want to ask you to subscribe to the YouTube channel if you haven't already. Also, press the bell icon to get notified for the next video, because that one is going to be awesome and you don't want to miss it. That being said, now let's start the tutorial. My setup is same as the previous video. I'm using Oracle Database 19c, which has one root container database, cdb$root, and one pluggable database, orclpdb. For the demonstration, I will be configuring HTTPS port for my pluggable database, orclpdb. Though I am using Oracle Database 19c, but the process will be same for Oracle 12c or 18c. For that matter, any Oracle database which is based on multi-tenant architecture. Anyways, now let's log on to the database.
Now we are connected to the database using the sys user. As we know that in all the newer versions of Oracle database, which are based on multi-tenant architecture, by default we are always connected to the root container. Let's check with which container we are connected right now. The container name is cdb$root, which is our root container. But as I mentioned earlier, that I want to configure the HTTPS port number for my pluggable database whose name is orclpdb. That means now I have to switch my container from root to pluggable. Let's do that. Session altered. Now to perform our further actions, we need to make sure that this pluggable database orclpdb must be open, not mounted. Let's quickly check if it is mounted or not. So, the pluggable database orclpdb is not open for read and write function. Rather, it is mounted. Now to set the HTTPS port for our Oracle Enterprise Manager, we need to open it. If you watched my last couple of tutorials, then you must know how to do that. If not, then don't worry, simply follow along. So let's open this pluggable database. Pluggable database altered. With this, we are all set to configure the port number for this pluggable database. Let's do that.
To set the HTTPS port number for the pluggable database, or even for any database whether it's pluggable or root container, we use a procedure. The name of this particular procedure is setHttpsPort. Similar to getHttps function, this procedure is also created inside the dbms_xdb_config package. Thus, to call it, we again need to use the dot notation, where we first write the name of the package, which in our case is dbms_xdb_config, followed by the dot and then the name of the procedure, which is setHttpsPort. This procedure takes only one argument. While specifying that argument, we need to make sure of two things, which are, first, this argument should be of number data type. No character, no string, no varchar. Second, this argument must always be a valid port number. Whatever port number you are specifying here should be free, otherwise you will get an error. In my case, I know that the port number 5510 is free and I can use it here. Let's do it. In Oracle database, we use execute command to run a PLSQL stored procedure. To do that, we can either write the keyword execute or just the starting four initials exec followed by the procedure call. In our case, that procedure call will be this. Let's do that.
That's all we have to do. PLSQL procedure successfully completed, which means we have successfully set 5510 as the HTTPS port number for the pluggable database over CLPDB. And we can use it to connect with Oracle Enterprise Manager using the pluggable database over CLPDB. Let's check. Here I am on my browser. In my case, the domain name is localhost. If you don't know your domain name, then check out my last video, as there I have showed the process of finding out the domain name for the Oracle Enterprise Manager. Link is in the description. Anyways, domain name localhost. Port number will be 5510. We just configured it, right? Using both these information, the URL for our Oracle Enterprise Manager will be this. As we have configured the port for HTTPS protocol, thus make sure to specify HTTPS in the URL, not the HTTP. Okay, let's log in. I will be using the sys user to log into my Oracle Enterprise Manager. Thus the username will be sys. I have set Oracle as the password for my sys user during the installation. This could be different in your case. Let's hit login. Here we go. Okay, if you will come to the upper left hand corner, then you will see that we are connected to our Oracle EM using the database over CLPDB.
That confirms that we have successfully logged onto the Oracle Enterprise Manager using the pluggable database over CLPDB. So you can use this process to configure a HTTPS port for any root container or pluggable database. So go ahead and enjoy. But make sure to subscribe, as in the next video, we will be learning more about Oracle Enterprise Manager. So that is how we manually configure a HTTPS port number for Oracle Enterprise Manager. Hope you learned something new. If so, then please hit the thumbs up button and like the video. Also, share this video with your friends on your social media. That's it for today. Thanks for watching. This is Vanish from RebellionRider.com.